Hello, this is Cristi. Let me show you how you can easily narrate a PowerPoint presentation in Camtasia. Camtasia offers an option to import PowerPoint presentations either as an actual PowerPoint or as individual images for each slide, and then allows you to narrate them in any order you like and for any duration you like to create a video presentation. So let me show you how it's done. I have a very simple presentation here created in PowerPoint, and it doesn't matter if it's for Mac or Windows. PowerPoint is PowerPoint, and I'm going to import this into Camtasia. There's two ways you can import it. You can either import the presentation itself in Camtasia by going to Camtasia Import Media, or by going to the File menu in a PowerPoint and then exporting it as a PNG or JPEG format. And you can choose to save every slide or just the current slide, whatever slide you want. I'm going to save every slide. And, you know, you just give it a name here at the top and it will add numbers automatically to the files. Let's click export. There you go. It's done. Every slide was saved. So now I go to Camtasia and I click import media. And usually PowerPoint creates a folder. And inside of that folder, you see slide 1, 2, 3 through 4. So that is one way to import the slides. But I will prefer to just import the PowerPoint itself because Camtasia is smart enough to know that it's a PowerPoint and it will create those images for me anyway. So click import. And Camtasia is asking, do you want to import all the slides? Yes, I do. Import. And there they are, 4 slides. And if you look at the file names, if you switch to the file view, you will see that these file names should be PNG images. 1920 by 1080 is the resolution, which is full HD, which is great. That's all I need. So I've got the 4 slides. I'm going to switch to thumbnail views. And now to narrate them. The easiest way to do it is to narrate one by one because you are presenting and you want to be maybe stopping through and maybe doing retakes. It's your choice what you do. And you can just start with the first slide, narrate that slide, and then put the second one on the timeline and so on. When I right-click on the first slide and say add to timeline, add playhead, it's important to know where is my playhead. It's right down here at the beginning if I have nothing on my timeline. So I'll just right-click and say add to timeline, add playhead. And there it is. And maybe, because my default project is 4K resolution, maybe I need to change the size. So you can go to the top here where the zoom level is and click on that and go to project settings. And in the project settings, you can see my default project is 4K, but I'm going to switch to full HD, FHD. 1920 by 1080 is exactly the size of my slides. Click on that and click apply. So there you go. Now my slide fits that scene, that area perfectly. You can zoom in and out with your mouse wheel, and there you go. So now my slide is on the timeline, and if I go to it, it's about 5 seconds long. The reason it's 5 seconds long is because that is the default in my Camtasia settings for the duration of any image I add to my timeline. You can change that default, but I wouldn't bother with that because you can also grab that slide and just expand it to be as long as you need it to be. Okay, so I'm going to leave it at 5 seconds for now, and let's add narration. The easiest way to add narration is to basically just place your playhead where you want to start narrating. Let's say here after the slide has shown up, and I'm going to go to the voice narration section in here. On the sidebar, voice narration, before you start talking, by the way, click here to check that you have the correct microphone selected. This is important because you want to record with the proper microphone that gives you the best audio possible. I'm going to use this microphone that I'm using right now. And you can see the check level as you speak. The level is bouncing up and down, and you can see that it's a good level. You can pull this up or down to change the sort of the gain if you want. So now that I've selected the area I want to record in the starting point, press start voice recording, and Camtasia is going to start recording from that point. Let's do it. You have a countdown. This is the first slide in my presentation. I'm not going to say much here because I don't have much to say, but also I want to see what happens if I stop recording. After you click stop recording, Camtasia is going to show you the recording on the timeline, and the slide finishes before I finish talking. Not a problem. Grab the slide and just expand it to last for as long as you need, right there. If you need to trim the audio, that is also easy. You can zoom in and say, you know, there was this pause at the beginning. I can just grab that audio clip portion and just trim it like this and trim the end as well. There you go. You can click on this to change the gain, to change the volume up or down. You can add compression to have your voice more consistent level if you go to the audio effects and just grab audio compression and add this to the audio file right there. And now your audio is more consistent. This is the first slide in my presentation. I'm not going to say much here. If your timing is off a little bit, you can just grab that audio file and slide it backward to start earlier. It's up to you. Now, what about recording the second slide? Not a problem. Let's go to the end and let's bring the second slide. Go to media and then the second slide, I'm just going to drag it down here on the timeline right there. And it's going to place it in the middle. So this is the second slide. And even if I have a gap in here, I can close this gap like this. And I can go and start narrating right there. Again, place your playhead where you want to start recording. And then go to the voice narration, start voice recording. Check your microphone is the right one. Click start. This is the second slide in my presentation, and it's very short. You click stop, and there you go. There's the audio. Make sure you add your audio effect again, audio effects compression. And if you want to trim the end or the beginning, zoom in and just grab the end and do it like this. Push it forward and grab the end of it. Camtasia always takes a few seconds to start and stop recording, so you don't want those to be part of your audio. So here you go, the changing of the slide. This is the second slide in my presentation, and it's very short. Quite nice. So if you do this, you can save, keep saving, you know, save it to your disk so that you make sure you don't lose your work. And by the end, you know, you will have your entire presentation nicely narrated from start to finish. It also helps if you want to add markers on the timeline so that you know where the slides begin, because it can be very hard to see what the slides are on the timeline. They do show the thumbnails, but if some of them look the same like the other ones, it can be hard to see. So in this case, I like to keep organized and add markers. So you can turn on markers from this little arrow here, change quiz to marker. And then when the second slide starts right here, I'm going to click on the timeline, click to add a marker. And you can give names to these markers. For example, I'm going to say slide 2. It starts there. And slide 1 obviously is at the beginning. I don't need a marker for it. But if I want to, click on this, slide 1. And there you go. You add markers to your timeline. Let's say I want to add the third slide right there. Click marker, slide 3, press enter. And now let's bring that slide, go to media, and right click, add to timeline. There's slide 3. I can be ready for narration right now. I'm not going to narrate anymore, but you get the point. So this is how you import a PowerPoint presentation into Camtasia and how you can narrate that easily in Camtasia using little chunks, little portions of your narration. You can delete those if some of them fail or you don't like the way they went. You want to do another take. You can delete that, start again, narrate the same slide over and over as many times as you need it to. I hope this was helpful. If you found this helpful, feel free to like it, subscribe to my channel, share it, and leave your comments and ask your questions. I'll be happy to answer them. Thank you again and see you on the next one.